Welcome. In this video, I'm going to go over the procedure to back up a Raspberry Pi running Raspbian Desktop to an SD card. So if you find this video helpful, I'll put a link in the description to the products I'm using on Amazon, and if you use that link, it helps me out a little bit and doesn't cost you anything extra. I'll also put a link to my Raspberry Pi playlist where you can find my other Raspberry Pi projects. So the setup I'm using right now is a Raspberry Pi 4, and in it I have a 64GB SanDisk microSD card. So I'm running a brand new instance of Raspbian Desktop, the full edition, Buster, but this could just as easily be your desktop you've been using for 4 months. So I'm going to right click on the backdrop and I'll say new file, and I'll just call this test. This is a test. I'll save that out. So after we back this up, we can check the new image to make sure it has this file. So I'm going to be backing this up to a Samsung 32GB microSD card. So the system currently is running on a 64GB card, and I'm backing up to a 32GB card. So long as you have spare room on your SD card, you can back up to a smaller card, as long as it'll fit on a 32GB card. So I'm going to plug in my card reader. I'm using a Transcend USB 3.0 card reader, and I'm going to be plugging this into the USB 3.0 slot. And you can do this on older Raspberry Pis. You're going to be using a 2.0 interface though, so it'll be a little bit slower. So it says removable media is inserted. I'll just hit cancel here. Next, I'll click up in the Raspberry Pi icon in the upper left, and I'll go to accessories and then SD card copier. I'll choose copy from device, and I'll choose the MMC-BLK0. So this is the internal microSD card. Then the copy to device is this TSRDF5SD. This is the Transcend reader. So now we have this option down here that says new partition UUIDs. If you want to make an absolute backup, so you're going to take this SD card and say stick it in a safe place, and then if your main SD goes down, you'll go retrieve it and put it in, you can leave your UUIDs the same. If you potentially are going to take this image and stick it into a second Raspberry Pi and boot it from there, then you might want a new UUID. So for this instance, I'll leave it unchecked, and then I'll hit start. It says erase all contents on the device TSRDF5SD Transcend, are you sure? I'll say yes. Now it's preparing it. So what this is going to do is it's going to format it, make the partitions, copy all the files over, and then you'll have your backup. Okay, so it says copy complete. I'll hit OK. I'll close this down. And I'll shut down the Raspberry Pi, and I'll put the SD card we just made inside. Okay, so now we're booted on the backup drive. So if you want to know how much space you have on your drive, you can open up a terminal and you can type df space dash h and hit enter. And here we see we have dev root. It says size is 29GB and we've used 5.8GB and we have 22 available. So you may want to do this on your large drive to make sure you have enough space free so you can copy it onto a smaller drive if that's what you're doing. Of course, the safest way is to get a larger microSD card as your backup drive. Then you definitely will be able to fit your smaller drive on it. So this is a technique you can use to back up your entire microSD card. But there are many other ways to back up. You can use rsync, you can use tar, compression algorithms, things like that. But this is just one way to do it. If you have any questions about this, please leave them in the comments. If you like this video, please click like. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, I'd appreciate it if you could do that. And thanks for watching. Until next time, goodbye.